Hello there, and welcome back to the Westmount Howl. Well, it certainly looks like third time is a charm. Each episode depends entirely on the level of involvement of our students and staff, and yet again, you have hit it out of the park by answering the call to share new items this week. Remember that if you have ideas for a segment or wish to be a contributor, you can always contact me at thewestmounthowl@gmail.com or at l.walter@tbdsb.ca. Let's first kick things off today with our view from the office. Mrs. Kaufman?
Hello, Westmount families. How are you? My name is Oreo, and I'm Ms. Kaufman's cat. I'm here to give you the office joke of the week. What did the cat say when the mouse got away? You have got to be kidding me. Oh, isn't that a good one? Well, anyway, Ms. Shamoon and Ms. Kaufman want me to give a huge shout out to the hard-working Westmount staff who have been doing their best to support our families during this time. And Westmount families, we want to meet your needs and we miss you. So if you need anything, please reach out to the school staff and let us know how we can help. Stay safe, and we hope to see you soon.
Thank you so much, Oreo and Mrs. Kaufman. You really are some cool cats. Oreo was not the only one with a joke up his fur this week. Here are two of our own wolves who decided to exercise their funny bones.
Where did you take a victim of the peekaboo accident? The ICU.
Why did the teacher write on the window?
Why?
She wanted the lesson to be very clear.
Thanks, you guys. I think I have another joke. Why was the music teacher not able to open her door? Because her keys were on the piano. No, I know, right? Her keys, get it? No, still no. If anyone else has a joke to share, you know where to send it. Speaking of music, once again, in the world of arts and entertainment, music continues to hold us together. This past week, the Westmount School community adopted a new anthem, a cover of John Denver's Country Roads by Miss Morton and myself called Viscount Road. We fully anticipate this to be our new farewell and send-off song for Westmount, the call to reminisce of the good times, the bad times, the crazy times, the quarantine times. How about just all the time? We hope you enjoyed it. If you missed it, the full song can be heard on the Westmount Howl's YouTube channel now. We know that you might be anxiously awaiting the next release, but you're just going to have to be patient. In other entertainment news, more students are coming out of the woodwork to showcase their talents and skills that they have been working on. Take a peek. Of music teachers in the Valley to be able to work with such skilled musicians, dancers, and overall artists. It is easy to say that the Westmount community truly appreciates your hard work and talents as well. Keep it coming. Speaking of appreciation, This past week included teacher and support staff appreciation days. I think that it would be appreciated if we took a moment right now to appreciate the appreciation of teachers and support staff shared in the following videos and photos sent in by students to show their appreciation.
It's Teacher Appreciation Week. I would like to give a shout out to Mr. Greason for doing an amazing job on the Google Meet and overall. Also to Ms. Walter for putting all these amazing Westmount Howls that keep our wolves connected and together. One last shout out to Madame Curry for keeping all our French spirits alive, and to all the other educators who are working very hard to prepare for next week. I am truly grateful. Happy Teacher Appreciation.
Yeah. Thank you, Miss Ensign, for teaching me and sending this word to keep us occupied.
Thank you, Miss Kelly, for keeping us occupied, and thank you for sending all the work.
Thank you, Miss Hindemeyer, for being a great teacher.
Thank you, Miss Knight, for sending all the work to keep us busy during these quarantine days. You've been such a great teacher.
Teachers and support staff, the verdict is in. We are amazing!
Yeah! Woo-hoo!
In case you were not already aware, today is Mother's Day. Oh, hold on. Just one second here.
Hello,
Mommy. Happy Mother's Day.
Well, hello. Thank you. What a surprise.
I just wanted to make sure I wished you a happy Mother's Day before I forgot.
Oh, you wouldn't forget. I know you. You wouldn't forget.
Well, thanks, Mommy. I'll be talking to you soon. I'm just in the middle of a broadcast here.
Okay. Well, thanks for calling. Make my day.
Okay, Mommy. Love you.
Love you too. Bye-bye. Okay,
bye. Sorry, mummies always have to come first. In recognition of all the amazing Westmount moms, here's a little photo collection you sent in to help us celebrate the Day of Mom. Nice surprise, a tea party for Mother's Day.
Can you make us some hot chocolate? We're having a tea party with our stuffies.
Oh. Happy Mother's
Day. No, let's try that again.
happy.
Mother's
Day.
To all the grandmoms, moms, and moms-to-be, stay safe and don't forget to
relax.
Thank you to our soon-to-be mom, Mrs. Shantz. We are so happy to see that you and baby are doing well. And to all the moms, once again, happy Mother's Day.
Hi, Westmount. This week's proud sponsor of the Westmount Howl is Hasbro's Game of Life. Your turn, Mitchell.
Pity.
So turn off your screens and enjoy a family game of adventure.
8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh!
Life is full of unexpected surprises. Will you get married, have children, have pets, or will you choose college or career?
Twins.
It's the game of life.
In other good news, there have been a few exciting developments this past week. And may I say a huge thank you to everyone who continues to allow us to share in your good news stories. The Driscoll family welcomed a new puppy into their household this week. What a perfect time to be at home to cherish a new member to the family, especially when this little pup might need a few reminders about the way things are done in a household. We are very happy for you guys and good luck. This week was also a very exciting time for our very own Gavin Roswell, who accomplished a goal that he'd set out for himself while at home in quarantine. Gavin has officially become a two-wheeler. On a bicycle, that is. Training wheels, schmating wheels. Gavin is now rocking out the bicycle like a pro. Way to go, Gavin. You're sailing now. Several students continued to celebrate their birthdays this week. Ali celebrated his 8th Super Mario birthday on Friday and got a surprise visit from the local fire department for a special birthday wish. Also, rumor has it that Isaac in grade 4 hits the double digits tomorrow. So, on behalf of all the staff and students of Westmount, happy birthday to all of those who have celebrated another year of greatness this past week. Ramadan continues into its 3rd week this coming week. Here is our very own Hamza to share one of his favorite traditions during this time of celebration.
Hello. I'm helping my mom do Ramadan pancakes. So it's basically curled up pancakes, and then you put some cream in it. Yeah, and then you dip it in pistachios, or like a bowl of pistachios, I don't know what that's called. And then when it's ready, you put syrup, it doesn't matter, but you put syrup on it, and then you eat it. It's really good.
Thank you, Hamza. If you happen to have any left over, I can think of a really good place that just might have space for them. The last of our good news goodies this week comes as a much anticipated update from our grade 7-8 teacher, Mr. Clark. Mr. Clark, we are absolutely thrilled to be hearing from you today.
Hello, Westmount. It's Mr. Clark here. Just wanted to update you guys on how my recovery's been going. I'm no longer at the hospital. I'm now home, which I'm very, very happy about. I would like to thank all of the Westmount students and staff and all of your kind thoughts and messages throughout the last number of months. They meant the world to me. I'm thrilled to be home, excited about how things are going. My message to you is stay safe in this hard time. Take care.
Once again, Mr. Clark, we are over the moon to hear that you are on the road to recovery, and we are so looking forward to being able to catch up with you very soon. Before we get to our next segment, here is our very own Malak with today's public service announcement.
Hi, Westmount Wolves. My name is Malak, and today I'm going to be showing you what you should wear if you're walking by yourself or with your family. A face mask, gloves.
Malak, where's the sanitizer?
Oh, here, Hamza. Bye.
Thanks, Malak. We like how you are always thinking safety first. Here with us again this week is Tate with Student's Voice.
Alright. No, turn it off. This is stupid.
I like Star Wars.
Alright, I think I'm ready now. Good morning, Westmount students. My name is Tate Stadnitsky. You might remember me from last week's Westmount Howl on the segment Student's Voice, where we had two students show off their talents. Well, we're going to be doing that again this time. First off, we have Lana in Mr. Harding's class showing off her amazing art skills. Here's some more of Lana's work. Quite impressive. Thumbs up. Don't start vacuuming! Okay, good. Never mind. But we didn't get any more submissions. What do we do? I think I know what to do. Tuning into this episode of Student's Voice. Back to you, Miss Walter, and may the force be with you.
And may the force also be with you. Lana, thank you so much for submitting your amazing artwork. And Tate, I think you're next in line for my job. Well, this week, it would appear that our students and families continue to be logged in, plugged in, and tuned in. Special shout out to Miss Kirkwood's FDKs for sharing some of their awesome art projects as well. Enjoy. Thanks again for sharing. It continues to bring smiles to our faces by seeing yours. Speaking of friendly faces, it's time to check in with Mr. D'Amico for the weather. Mr. D'Amico?
Thanks, Miss Walter. Let's go take a look outside right now and see what the weather is like. Seriously?
Well, that was certainly unexpected. Snow? In the world of fitness this week, many households happily embraced the catchy and highly regarded song, Baby Shark. To update us in our fitness forum, as always, is our very own Mr. Sanders.
And thank you once again, Miss Walters. Good to hear your voice. Welcome, Wolfpack. Once again, we are reporting from the fitness forum on this week's events. First off, thank you to all who participated in the Baby Shark Challenge. I must say, it was probably the most entertaining highlight of my week, watching your videos and looking at your photos. Well done. A few special shout outs. First one goes to Jamie and Reed M. They had perfect unison together as they were doing the challenge. The Wood family, congratulations. You did a great job as well in terms of participating. Miss Kirkwood and Miss Say, nicely done, ladies. And Luke M, also under the wire yesterday, got his submission in just in time. Grade 3, special shout out to you. You were 1 point away from winning this challenge. It was very good to see another group of classes come together to try to win. Once again, though, for the fourth week in a row, FDKs, you win the Baby Shark Challenge. Next up for next week, we have some different activities in your Google Classrooms. Plus, the challenge is called Stuck to Me. It is the Stuck to Me Challenge. Please visit your classrooms. If you need directions, please send me an email and I will send you the link. Take care, stay safe, see you next week.
Thank you, Mr. Sanders. And we are really relieved that you survived a week long of watching and listening to the Baby Shark Challenge videos without many side effects. Few people would survive the onslaught of Baby Shark on repeat.
Nothing.
And now, a word from our sponsor.
Westmount Howl is brought to you by board games! Fire up your family's competitive spirit with a great board game!
You cheated!
No, I didn't!
Yes, you did!
I quit!
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Fun, right? Board games!
Well, there you have it. Another week, another howl. Westmount continues to be wondrous because our staff, students, and families continue to be wonderful. Stay tuned into your Google Classrooms, the Westmount Facebook pages, and your blast emails for next week's Focus for Contributions. It is because of you that the Westmount Howl continues to stay on the air. So, in the meantime, stay safe, stay healthy, wash your hands, and keep on howling.